Hello, people. We are going to talk about where the fuck is my C drive under Linux? Or where's my hard drive? If you're used to Windows and stuff like... Oh, we actually have updates here. Let's do that later. You'll be used to have a C, E, E, F, G drive and stuff like that. But when you go onto Linux, you're like, I don't have that. But we do... If you look here, I have Pop OS. This is my main drive. Oh, sorry. This is the USB stick I just put in, and we have something called here writable. If you go into other locations, we have computer. So it's kind of laid out for you a little bit like on the Windows. So computer here, that could be your C drive or your Windows drive, what you will call it. And these down here is my USB, basically, that has two partitions on it. That we will then, if you look on the Windows, they will be called, you know, D, you know, B, E, F, G, whatever drive letter Windows automatically assigned to it. It's not like that on the Linux. So why is that? Why don't we have, you know, the A, B, C, D drives as we have on the Linux, or Windows, sorry. Linux don't do that. Linux use something called a file tree, which is basically everything is putting into one file system. So if we look here, you know, this is my my Pop OS DVD, not DVD, USB I have here. My brain is all over the place today. But if I hover over it here, you can see it says /media/test/, and then the name of the drive. But that basically is the same as D under Windows, or C or G or F or whatever Windows assigned. That's basically the drive letter. But why is it called /media/test/pop OS? And, you know, that thing is because Linux put everything into a file, into one big file system. And it's because everything under Linux, and the same with Unix, is either a file or a folder. Even your hard, your physical hardware, if you look at it in the file system, it's represented as a file or a folder. Don't want to explain that, but you go read up about that if you want to. But if you go in here, this is our C drive, you know, our root drive, as we call it under Linux. And it's the one, the forward slash. That's indicated as root, the forward slash. So if you look down here, oh, we have to find a folder, because the folder name come after the forward slash. That's in the root file system, or the beginning of the file system, called media. So if we look in here, oh, we have one here called media. So if I click that one here, and we look again, well, now we're in the media folder. So it put a forward slash in front of it. So let's do test. That's this one here. And this is where we have my USB device that has two partitions on it. So instead of just you popping it in and it's assigning it drive D or G or something like that, it's putting it into a folder that is coded by Linux to, say, put it on the media. Another way is looking at it, if you go into the command line here, again, I'm trying to give you as many virtual aids there as possible, is that if you go out to the root drive and you do that by doing change directory cd forward slash, because forward slash indicate the start of your file system. And I would explain a little bit easier how we should think about the Linux file system. So if you pwd print working directory, we are in C. Oh, sorry, not E. Yeah, well, what you would call C under Windows. But here it's the root and it's done with a forward slash. So if we do list, you can see we have all of the folders in here. Probably a little bit hard for you guys to see, but this here, we are now in here. So if I go in here and I do change directory to media, and it puts a forward slash in there, and I list what's in there, there's something called test. So if I change directory to test and I list it again, this is now my Pop OS installed, and I'm sorry for the theming I have here. So basically, look at it like this. I kind of say it a little bit like this, but when you're changing directory, you go in a door into a new room, and that door is just a folder. So what I did here is that I did this. I went into the root of my file system. I found the media folder. So I opened the door into the media folder. I went in there. Oh, I had a test. I opened the door and went in there. Now I have my DVD. So what Linux does with this file system here is that it's, when you're plopping in an external device, or a hard drive, DVD, whatever it is, it puts it into the existing file system. So a little bit easier way, I think, of how to look at it is, if you're going in and playing Bob Ross, I don't want to restore with paint. Okay, I had to go to Firefox because there's apparently an update for Chrome. So an easy way to think about how the root file system is made. And why is it called the root file system is, let me explain a little bit. So let's pretend we have a tree here. And the Linux world is like, well, the file system is the root of the tree, you know. The root, it's the beginning. And then you put branches on it here and you go out to different folders. I think this is a little bit better way of explaining it. So root, you know, that's done with a forward slash. We have that right here. So I look at it as a path, a road that you walk on, that you go down. So we have the beginning of the file system here. Then we have a path into a folder here. A path into another folder here. We have a path into a 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 folder here, and so on and so on. So when you're adding in another device, a D drive, what would become a D drive or something like that on the Windows, what Linux do is that in this folder here, down this path, you're walking this road, you're going into this city or village, it's adding a new road where your DVD or USB is. So you're just walking down here. Oh, I want to go in here. I want to go in down here. And then I go in here. This is now your USB. If I can spell to USB. Get what I'm trying to say here. And then there is a path from here into the folders you have on your USB stick. Again, I look at it as a road. And when you're not using a... when you're unplugging your USB stick, that road is being cut off. There's guard in front of it. It's not here anymore. It don't exist. It's been taken out of the realm of possibilities. Universe, if you believe in multiple universes, it's been eaten up by a black hole until you plug it in again. So this is how I look at the file system. And that's why you don't have a D drive or a C drive or anything like that under Linux. Is that it's just adding it's just plugging the path to your hardware or your hard drives or your peripherals, you know, your USB sticks and stuff like that into the file system. So you just can, you know, walk that road into, you know, open the door into the new file system the new device that you just opened. And it can be a little bit confusing to think about that. And root, it's the start of the file system. I don't know if it should have another name, but if you think about it as a path, you know, as a road. So the root of the file system, this here, you're now looking at a road in front of you. And all of these folders here is a door or a pathway that leads to another road, you know, another path, sorry. So let's say I want to go in again. I want to find the village or I want to find the path to my USB device. So I'm going down this road. I'm starting here at the beginning of my road. So I have to go down the path that's called media. You know, we have a sign that says media this way, etc that way. So I want to go down to media because that's where Linux will have put it in. So I go down the media path, and then there's another road sign that says test this way. So I go down the test road, and now I have, PopOS is this way. Writable is this way. Okay, I want to go into PopOS, so I go in here. That's how I think about it. And then, again, when I unplug my USB device, that road or that road sign is being taken away, thrown into the ditch, and it's guarded off. You can't get in there anymore. But you can still go down the other path there. I don't know if that's more easy for you to think about or if it's easier for you to think about it as a hierarchy, because you can also think about it like that. But I kind of... imagine it like this, and why I do that is because I spend a lot of time in here in the command line, because in here it makes a little bit sense. You know, we start out here. This is the start of our road. Let's see what path we have on our road. We have a lot of path. Let me go into media, go down the media path, It's the media trail on our road. So I say, do CD change directory or let me walk into the media path. Now I walked into the media path. Now there's a cross section, or depending on how many folders is and stuff like that. But now I have another choice. What path do I take? Let's see what choices I have. I only have one choice. Go in down the test path. So I just go down the test path. Now I'm at another choice I can make. And that is proper ways of writable. So now there is a Y in the road. Which way do I go? And that's why I find this a little bit easier to think about the file system like that, because I'm in here, I'm using the terminal a lot. But if you're looking at it here, it's just that's why they say in Linux everything is a file or a folder. So when you're plugging in your USB device, it's just Linux automatically is just like, okay, we have now agreed upon this is Ubuntu. They have then said, okay, everything that you mount with a USB is putting into media. Kind of makes sense, media. It could also have been MNT. That was in the olden days. We put it into MNT for mount. But nowadays it's media. Like, yeah, it's a media device. It's a USB device. So Ubuntu is like, we are putting every USB device on the media, and then the name of the USB device, we are adding that as a folder instead of as a disk drive. We are adding it as a folder, plugging it in or into your file system, or we are adding another path you can go down on your road that is your file system. Or giving you another branch to the tree that you can go out and sit on and kiss girls or boys. So I'm clicking on it here and going into it like that. So that's why we don't have this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and what, you know, unlimited, as long as there are numbers in the alphabet, of course, numbers in front of our drives on the Linux, is because Linux don't separate the drives for you or the you know, the peripherals in that way. It separates mouse and keyboards, but storage devices, it don't separate storage devices like it does under Windows. That's a Windows philosophy that they are like, okay, it's easy for the end user if we separate the A drive, the B drive, the C drive, and blah, 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 blah. It's easy for them to understand. But Linux is like, no, it makes a little bit more sense if we're just adding them in. Well, it's actually the Unix way of doing it. If we're adding it into the existing file system as a folder instead of making it look like it's two separate things. So it all looks like one. Actually, it looks like, if you think about it, it's like one organic entity, the file system, to some extent. It keeps growing and growing and growing and growing. But under Windows, C drive to C drive, D drive is D drive. That's it. They don't look like they are one thing. Even though on a sub-level they are, if you go into how the file system works. But for you, they are separate. Under Linux, they are one thing. Your USB device is basically just a folder. Now under your main file system or root file system or what you will call it. But again, yeah, everything is a file, everything is a folder. You will hear that a lot with Linux people. So yeah, see you all later. Bye-bye.